Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to another episode. There is a message that was sent to me by one of our brother. Strange things do happen in this world. The message reads like this. Hello, brother Nashi, how are you? I have my own story that I want to share with you. When I came here to South Africa, I started to work as a gardener. I was doing a lot of piece jobs. The money that I was making at that time, it was close to nothing. And it took me the whole year for me to save money that was somewhere around 9,000 rands. That was all that I could save. So since I came from a very poor village, all that I wanted was to open up a small spaza shop. And in our village, for you to have a very small spaza shop, you are considered to be someone that has a lot of money. So just before I had returned back to Zim, I still remember this other day when I felt so thirsty, I said, let me go to this other Somalian spaza shop. He was like a friend of mine. And when I went there, unfortunately, I met some young guys that were there. They said that they wanted to rent so that they can buy some cigarettes. I told them that I did not have any money, but they had seen me buying a 2-liter cold drink with the 200 rent that I had. Then they started to follow me and they said that we saw you buying some items there. We want that money. So I started to run, and when I ran, I then locked myself in my room, and these guys, they actually broke the door, because when they jumped the drawer, they saw that there was no one else but me in that yard. So they broke the door, and when they broke the door, I saw that they were holding their okapi knives. It was a lot of them. And then they told me that they wanted all the money that I had in my room, and they said that we know you guys from Zim, you do not bank your money, you keep your money underneath your mattress. Then they said, we want the money. So this money, I was hiding it in a 12.5 of millimil. I had one that I had opened up, but I had never used it. That was where I was hiding the money. So these guys, they started threatening me, and they said that they were going to stab me, until finally I showed them that inside that 12.5 of millimil, that is where I had hidden the money. They opened it up, and then they saw a small black plastic, and they saw that indeed this was the money that I had. Then they took it and they all ran away. This was really painful, and I struggled a lot from there on until I had raised some money. I then returned back home, and when I returned back home, this was the time when the powerful traditional healer from Chipinge, who was called Ndunge, he was still alive at that time. I went, and when I went there and I spoke with him, and I told him everything that had happened. And when I went to him, he said, why have you come to my compound when you do not have any money at all? And I told him that I had heard about him. A lot of people knew about this powerful traditional healer, but I had heard him on the news, and he was on the radio telling people that if they have any problems, they can come to his place. So that is why I was at his place. He said that he was going to assist me, but since I did not have any money, and I wanted this man that had robbed me in South Africa to lose their minds, then it meant that I was supposed to give him something in return. I said, why, what do you want in return? He then told me that there was one man whom he had given this other snake. It was a black mamba that he had once given to this other man. So this man, unfortunately, he had since passed away. So this snake, when they had created that altar, the snake, it was supposed to be handed over to one of his sons, but unfortunately the son had also passed away. So this snake, it was giving him a lot of sleepless nights, not because it was attacking him, no, it was too much powerful, but it kept on coming to him and crying and saying that it wants some food, and it wants him to take this snake so that it can also stay at his compound with some of his tokoloshes. But he said that that was not what he wanted to do. So if it was possible, if he was going to assist me to call upon the souls of these young South African men, six of them that had robbed me, into his shrine, into his consulting room, then he was going to make them to go mad, but in return he was going to give me this snake so that the snake can become mine. So this was like a deal that we had to do, since I did not even have the money to return back home, yet alone the money to pay for the consultation fees. I agreed, and he promised me that if I was going to treat this snake very well, it is a snake that vomits money. So he called that snake, he taught me how to whistle properly so that the snake can hear me and it can come. So he taught me for about 30 minutes. I was unable to whistle like properly, but after I had managed to do that, then I saw the snake. He told me that the snake at that time, it was staying in the mountains. Since it was like an orphan, it did not have any home. It quickly came. Then he told me that he was going to prepare some soft porridge, and he prepared some soft porridge made out of sorghum, and then he gave that clay plate to me that was filled with the soft porridge that was made out of sorghum, and I gave that snake. And from that day onwards, that was when I got that snake that was going to vomit money so that I can become rich. But there was more that was going to be needed. He called upon the names of those young men, six of them. They were transported in the spirit from South Africa, and then they were brought into his consultation room. I saw them, they stood before me, and they were shocked and when they saw that it was I, the man that they had robbed when I was still in their country. They begged for forgiveness, but it was already too late. Mundunge then gave me his walking stick, and he told me that all that I had to do, one by one, I had to walk and place that walking stick on top of their heads. So one by one, I would go and stand in front of them, and then I'll place that walking stick on top of that guy's head. Then he will disappear. The soul will disappear until the last one, the number six. And I also did the same ritual, and he disappeared. That man then told me that forever these guys, they were going to run mad, and there was no one who was going to be able to cure them unless if they managed to come to his compound, because he was the one who knew how he had created this altar of madness, and it was only him with his powers that could undo everything that he had done. By the time that I returned back to South Africa this time around, when I came here, I had just came here to buy a few trucks so that I can return back home, because already the snake had started to vomit some money. I just deliberately went back to that location where I was staying, and I looked for an accommodation, and I started staying there because I wanted to see if indeed these guys were running mad. So the stories that I had was that these guys, then they started to smoke some weed that was mixed with nyaupe, and then they got addicted to nyaupe, and slowly but surely they started to lose their minds. So everyone in that community thought and was blaming the drugs, saying that the drugs were the ones that made them to lose their minds. But what they didn't know was that there was a spirit that was behind. I watched as these guys' health were declining until they started to stay in the city, and they are all madmen. It has been a long time since I saw these guys, and after that I then returned back home. And before I had came here to South Africa, my mom, she had been bitten by a snake. On that day that my mom passed away, she had returned back from the fields, and she felt too tired. She then retired to her bedroom. Whilst she was sleeping on her bed, then she had her window opened up, because it was way too hot in the area where I come from. It is really hot. So she had her window opened up. Then the snake slowly climbed up the wall and entered into her bedroom. It ended up biting her on the neck, and those that know how much poisonous a black mamba is, you know that if it bites you on the neck, then it is over for you. My mom screamed in pain, then it kept on biting my mom. People ran into her bedroom. I also did the same. Then the snake ran away. People cried when they saw that my mom had been beaten repeatedly by that black mamba on her back area as well as on her neck. So there was no way, it was not possible, like, to tie around the area where my mom had been beaten by this black mamba. So it was over for her. People knew that there was no need for us to take my mom to the clinic because of the place where she had been bitten by this snake. My mom slowly passed away. And when she passed away, she just whispered my name. But people did not understand why she was whispering my name, because before she had died, it was revealed to my mom that the way that she had been bitten by that snake, this was not a real snake, but a spiritual one that had bitten her. And this was a sacrifice. I had sacrificed my mother. That is how I sacrificed my own mother. Dear listeners, right there was a message that was sent to me by one of our dear brother right there. Strange things do happen in this world. Then there is another message that was sent to me by our dear sister. So the message, it reads like this. Hello, Brother Nashi, how are you? So I cheated on my husband, but I slept with my friend's husband, like my best friend. So at that time, my best friend, she had returned back home to Zim, and as for me, my husband was busy with work. So then I spoke with my friend's husband. He asked me if I had cooked anything. Then I told him that if he wanted some food, he can pass through my place. So he came, then we started to have a conversation. But Brother Nashi, me and this guy, we started touching each other, and we ended up sleeping with each other without using any protection. I felt so guilty because of the things that I had done. Then the other thing that I did is that I then went to my friend's house at that time when she was still back home in Zim. Then I took one of her husband's underwear. I stole it. The reason as to why I stole it, it is because I have been thinking that if it happens that I get divorced from my husband, then I will be able to use his underwear so that I can do a bring back lost lover. If my marriage is going to fail, I also want my friend's marriage to fail as well. This is what I did. So, dear listeners, right there was a brief narration of a message that was sent to me by one of our dear sister right there. Strange things do happen in this world.